My name is Hamad Khan, and I am the Data Management Librarian here at UTA Libraries. Today's presentation is about data hygiene, best practices for keeping your data clean. This presentation will cover best practices and tools used for data cleaning and how we can practice good data hygiene, which is an ongoing process of keeping data clean. Now, if you look at this photo, it is a bar of soap with the words data hygiene. I want you to not think about the word data for a second and just focus on this word hygiene. When we think of hygiene, we think of conditions and practices in maintaining health and preventing diseases, especially through cleanliness. If you do not practice good hygiene, your health can deteriorate, which can lead to several problems. So daily, you do a basic routine that keeps you clean and healthy. One of the best examples is washing your hands with soap. You wash your hands to get rid of germs, so when you eat or rub your eyes or touch your face, you are not causing germs in your hands to affect other parts of your body. So cleanliness is really important. Data provides evidence, but quality data provides strong evidence. The term data quality refers to the suitability of data to serve its intended purpose. Just ask yourself one simple question. Is your data fit for use? It will be in either a yes or no. But let's say you're unsure, and even if you are sure, you need to assess the quality of your data. Measuring data quality involves performing data quality assessments to determine the degree to which your data adequately supports what you are trying to answer. A data quality assessment is done by measuring particular features of the data to see if they meet defined standards. Each such feature is called a data quality dimension and is rated according to a relevant metric that provides an objective assessment of quality. Now, there is no set standard definition of data quality dimensions, but these listed on the screen are perhaps the most mentioned and discussed when assessing data quality. Now, if your data is not complete, there is no conformity, consistency, accuracy, there are duplicate records, then you are dealing with dirty data. What makes data dirty? Well, it's inconsistent, noisy, and incomplete. Inconsistent, containing discrepancies in codes or names. So for example, you're originally rating something in your data 1, 2, 3, but then all of a sudden you become inconsistent and start rating that same item as A, B, or C. For noise, think about when you make a phone call. You want to hear the person's voice, but all you hear is static or distortion in their voice, which you could say is noise. Same with a data set. Sometimes you have variables or information that you do not need and will not be important for your analysis. The meaningless information is the noise, which you want to get rid of. With a phone call, when you get noise on the other end, you hang up and try again. With noisy data, you have to clean the data set to get the useful data points you would like to analyze. Another thing that makes data dirty is that attribute values are incomplete. Now, how does data become dirty? Well, if you look at it, if you are not practicing good data hygiene, that's when data becomes dirty. Hygiene begins from the data collection point, and it continues until all data is analyzed. So how does data become inconsistent? Well, there are different data sources, non-uniform naming conventions. How does data noise come about? You're using a faulty instrument to collect data, human or computer errors during data entry. Data transmission from one device to another is not sufficient. How do we have incomplete data? You forget to enter data values. You use different criteria between the time when the data was collected and when it was analyzed, and human hardware software problems. Now, if you have dirty data, there is nothing to be ashamed of because most data at one point in time is actually dirty, and all that it requires is data cleaning, which is the process of detecting, correcting, or removing corrupt or inaccurate records from Excel sheets or tables. So, here we have four steps of data cleaning. Screening involves systematically looking for suspect features in assessment questionnaires, databases, or analysis of data sets. The diagnosis is identifying the nature of the defective data, and treatment is when you're deleting, editing, or leaving the data as it is. Phases of data cleaning requires an in-depth understanding of all types and sources of errors possible during data collection and entry processes. Documenting changes entails leaving an audit trail of errors detected, alterations, additions, and error checking, and will allow a return to the original value if required. If you follow good practices for data cleaning, you are practicing good data hygiene, which leads to quality data. So this image gives us an example of identifying noise. Here you see the noise as you move to the right of on the x-axis. The noise becomes ever greater until the points simply appear totally random. Those points are outliers and would actually require you to go back to your data set and find where there is an inconsistency among those random points. This can be time consuming, and it's said that the most time spent with data is actually cleaning the data. So you will probably spend more time cleaning data than collecting and analyzing data, and that is normal. But if you practice good data collection, which is really the key to good clean data, set standards for what you are recording and keeping organized with your version control, then you will spend less time cleaning data. If you do this, you can have quality data. So the most common problems you may encounter with dirty data or messy data is that your column headers are values, not variable names. Multiple variables are stored in one column. Variables are stored in both rows and columns. Multiple types of observational units are stored in the same table. A single observational unit is stored in multiple tables. Spelling mistakes in data such as names, addresses are always difficult to identify and correct. Misfielded value problems occurs when the values entered are correct as far as format is concerned, but does not belong to the field. Example: in field of city, value recorded is Germany. But like we said, these are avoidable with good data collection practices, and our goal is to get quality data. So what is quality data? Well, it's accuracy. The values contained in each field of the database record should be correct and accurately represent real-world values. Example: a recorded address should be a real address. Names should be spelled correctly. Completeness. The data should contain all the necessary and expected information, and the scope of the data element should be understood by the user. No required element should be missing or in an unstable state. Example: if first and last name are required in a form, but middle name is optional, the form can still be considered complete if no middle name is entered. Consistency. Consistency is recorded data should be the same throughout the organization and across all systems. Watch out for conflicting information between data sets, records, and systems. Conformity. Data should conform to certain standards of type, size, format, etc. So an example is all dates should be in the format of month, day, year format. Names should use only letters, not numbers or symbols. Uniqueness. One real-world entity should correspond to only one thing in your data. Duplicate entries should be eliminated. Example: if you have a company record with the name Dunkin' Donuts and another with the name Duncan, one record should be deleted, ideally the one that doesn't reflect Duncan's preferred name. Integrity. The data should be valid across relationships, meaning that there are recorded relationships that connect all the data together. Note that unlinked records may introduce duplicate entries in your system. Example: if you have an address recorded in your database, but there is no person, company, or other relationship associated with the address, the data is invalid and it is considered an orphaned record. Timeliness. The data should be available when it's expected and needed by the user. Whether data is timely depends on user expectations. An example is, hotel booking site should update availability records in real time, while a billing system may only need to update once per day. If you have any questions, please email me at hamad.khan@uta.edu. And for any general questions regarding your data, please email datacave@uta.edu. Thank you for watching this presentation.